thank you so much for being here with me, my distinguished listeners. This is Every Woman with me, Empress Golding. We're coming to you live from the traditional radio, Nationwide 90 FM, 90.3, 90.5, 90.7, 90.9 on the FM band. Special hello to all my listeners in the diaspora all across the world, streaming with me on Nationwide 90 FM's YouTube channel. If you were listening to the show earlier, you would have heard the Minister of Education and Youth, the Honorable Fayval Williams. She joined me for the Daily Lunch Show to talk about education, the return of school. And I still haven't got my school books. Oh, God, to every mom knowing and listening. Oh, beg you some grade 5 books if you're listening and you want to recycle. Drop them off at the studio for me. Kusha's going to grade 5. I can't believe it. But now we're moving into another part of education. And it's the other E. The E I love. Not Empress. I love myself. And you must love up on yourself. But it's entrepreneurship. Minister Williams still with me. Minister of Education, Youth, Member of Parliament for St. Andrew Eastern. So how are you enjoying the Daily Lunch Show, my lady?
Oh, good. No. Wow. You know, the excitement is catching, man.
Listen, I'm excited about growth, and I'm excited about this project that you have going on in your constituency. And Keisha is joining us. Let me introduce her, Minister Keisha Bailey. Let's welcome her to the show. CER of Project Jumpstarter. Keisha, welcome.
Thank you for having me.
Yes, I'm going to allow Minister to tell me about the program.
I'm delighted that these young people have decided to give back by having this young entrepreneurship session with young people in the constituency of St. Andrew Eastern. What's great about it as well, too, is that Keisha, who's here, is from August Town.
Yes.
No, that's massive. That's massive. And then we have Ricardo. One and One. He'll be there as well.
That's One and One Educational Services.
One and One Educational Services from Hermitage. He has his roots in Hermitage.
Oh, he's from Hermitage.
Yes. And then you have Tyrone Wilson, iCreate. Mm-hmm. He has some connection with Kintyre, which is across the Hope River area from Augustown there. So it's great to have these young people come back and relate with persons who are there in the community to help them understand. As the topic says, it's not where you are now. Mm. It's where you want to get to.
It is not where you're from. It's where you want to go. Yep. And we have to show other young people that greatness can come from where they are, that there's hope for them and opportunity. So it's happening on September 4. Tell me the details. Let's start with you, Keisha. What you do? You come from Augustown. What you really do, boss lady?
So I am what you call a money connoisseur. I know money well. I'm an investment strategist and CEO of Profit Jumpstarter. I like to think of myself as, you know, the money guru because I've always managed money throughout my career. And these days through Profit Jumpstarter, that is what I do. Investment, education, and strategy. I teach people strategies to implement to take them into wealth, specifically US 1 million or more.
No.
Whoa.
Minister, you see who we have in lunch?
I know.
She says it with such confidence.
Yes.
I like it. Yeah. I am on my vision board. I'd like to make 1 million US in the next 12 months with Keisha. You're going to impart so much knowledge on the constituents, right, of St. Andrew Eastern on September 4. What does the program look like and who will be attending from the constituency?
We'll have young people. We're looking for young people who are 20 plus, thereabout, to come and be there with us and with all the presenters, talk, come with their questions. There'll be no stupid question. Come with it, help you to understand where you are. Even if you're just dreaming to be an entrepreneur, you should come to this session. And Empress, I want to say, before we get going much further, we really want to thank First Heritage Cooperative Credit Union and Kingston Jerk. Without them, it would not have been possible because, you know, these things take money to put on. And they are sponsors. Lauren Peart as well will be there as one of the presenters. And, you know, he's into analytics, helping us to look at big data and make sense of it. So that will be just, I think, very exciting as well.
It does take partnership to make the dream work. So how do the listeners, before we go into more of Keisha's presentation and some of the other presenters, I don't want you to give them everything now, Keisha, but a little jump start, a little kickstart of what we're going to experience. Can you please tell us how do these young people, 20 plus, apply or do they just turn up? Minister, what is the
right
criteria?
So I would love for them to turn up in Hermitage Park on Sunday afternoon at 5 p.m. We've sent out flyers all over the place. We've physically dropped off some flyers as well, and I'm going to have a town crier going around to remind them to come out, mm-hmm. turn out, because this is a very important session that we're having in the constituency. And again, I am so thrilled that these four young persons who are excelling mm-hmm. in their field. You just heard Keisha talk about $1 million minimum.
Yes.
Minimum.
And you talked about big data. And I know that Lauren Peart, CEO of Blue Dot Insights, is a big part of some of the commissioned reports that we've asked for out of here mm-hmm. in Nationwide and other public data that we've seen. Keisha, we mentioned, from Augustown. Tyrone Wilson, President and CEO of iCreate Institute from Kentucky. You mentioned, and Ricardo Allen, the other speaker, president and CEO of One-on-One Educational Services Limited. And I see that some of them have hit the stock exchange, the junior stock exchange.
Yes, that's amazing. Honestly, when you think about it,
fabulous.
It's amazing that we have our young people. They launch companies in industries that they are generating revenues, generating mm-hmm. profits, and they're able to convince investors to come along with them to expand mm-hmm. these companies. It is amazing.
It is amazing.
Where we are in 2022.
And what we lack a lot of times when we talk about education, it's the right education and the right information.
Yes.
And we know that math and science is great, but it's more than that. And education comes from the people you know and the people you have lunch with, like me today. I'm about to get rich. So, Keisha.
Fayval,
you feel it? No.
Yes.
It.
Right next door.
Touch me, Toman.
I know.
Well, I love it. So, we are smiling, we are talking money.
Exactly.
It feels good. Yeah. But Keisha, you know, along the way, we talked earlier, Minister alluded to mentorship, you know, that third that may not be there, it needs a one-on-one, it needs that mentorship. Who helped you along the way? What is it that made you successful to be able to have the confidence to step out and start this and now give back? Tell me what it is, a snapshot, I should say, of the journey.
So, growing up, I always felt that, you know, there has to be more than life. We'd wake up and you see people dying, gunshot send you to sleep, gunshot wake you up in the morning. But then I always felt there was more to life. There had to be more. And it's when I started high school at Campion College, mm-hmm. big up yourself.
All right.
So
yes.
Going there, I saw that, you know, there's a whole other world outside of Augustown, because the furthest I would have gone was, you know, Papi in Ligani. But there was a whole other world outside of that little mm-hmm. community. And mm-hmm. the more I explored, the more I thought, you know, I need to make it out of here. I need to. And I've always felt that it is my mission. I don't know where does God place it on me that I have to learn so that I can help those who are coming behind me. Mm. And so school is my thing. I love the books. I love learning. So went to a lot of school. Actually stopped school at 30. So whole heap of schooling in
whole
finance.
Heap of schooling. Yeah.
But my mentorship came when I started working. And the more I was exposed to investing and how that really could transform your life, mm-hmm. I said, look here, this is it. I'm running with it. Mm-hmm. And so I sought out a lot of persons who were already wealthy, mm-hmm. spoke to them about what their habits, their principles were, and started implementing that in my life. Mm-hmm. Made it all the way to Toronto to managing over $100 billion Canadian dollars.
Oh, you heard that? You heard that, Empress? You heard that?
In the universe, I'm putting it into my account.
Yes. So, but I still knew I needed to make that impact. So left the corporate world to start Profit Jumpstarter, where I work with clients now to teach them how to get to that million or more, because I've done it so many times for other persons mm-hmm. and other pension funds, institutions, and so forth. I wanted to be able to do the same thing now for the everyday people, my people.
Yeah, my people. So, my people.
So Empress, the other day when I spoke at the Jamaica Teachers Association, uh-huh. I mentioned financial planning for teachers. That to me,
that's
you know, it,
and,
it, And we are going to act. Yes. We already spoke with financial sector companies, and they are eager to jump on board in terms of a series of sessions with our teachers to help them understand where they are right now financially. How can they move from where they are to where they want to be down the road? It's a powerful program. It's going to be a powerful series of programs for our teachers.
And we need that, because we're going to take a break. When we come back, I want to just expound on that for just a couple minutes, because as women, we must have multiple streams of income. I'm big on it, and we have to show men how. Yeah, nobody in the world has one stream if they're successful.
Too close to no stream.
All right, when we come back, we're talking about education, right, for our young constituents in St. Andrew Easton. Come out to Hermitage Park Sunday, September 4 at 5 o'clock. Great young lecturers. You're going to be filled with knowledge to make you wealthy and healthy when we come back after this break.
PH Paints have been serving Jamaica for 60 years and have become a household name, providing quality products and services while contributing to the growth of our country. Explore their wide range of product offerings and find the perfect product to turn your dreams into painted reality. Contact their experienced staff today at 876-923-7131 or 3, or email jamaica@harrispaintsonline.com. Paint it, love it with BH Paints.
Monkeypox is in Jamaica. If you are experiencing fever, intense headache, muscle aches, and or rash on the skin, you must isolate immediately and call ahead to your health center or doctor before visiting. All members of the public should wear a mask, frequently wash hands, and practice physical distancing. A message from the Ministry of Health and Wellness.
Need to make a change to your title or need a title? Geoland Title Limited. They do lost title application, add and remove names from titles, wills, estates, first-time registration land surveys also included, affordable rates and flexible payment options. NLA adjudication and land titling waivers also available. They have 8 locations island-wide. Call 876-754-6436 or visit their website at geolandonline.com. Geoland Title Limited. Secure your land, secure your title.
Ladies and gentlemen, on September 4, 5 o'clock at Hermitage Park, right? Young constituents, come out if you are 20 plus. It's going to be an educational session on entrepreneurship, how to create, to dream, to invest, to have multiple streams of income. That's the education that the Minister of Education and Youth, but in her capacity of Member of Parliament for St. Andrew Easton, will be facilitating alongside some great entrepreneurs. And one is with me, Keisha Bailey, CEO of Project Jumpstarter. Before the break, if you missed it, they were telling us about the program, all of the speakers, and what the recipients will get. If you missed it, head on over to Nationwide90FM's YouTube channel and stream for this information. You can watch it all tonight, tomorrow, and share it with your friends. Minister, we have about 10 more minutes with you on the Daily Lunch Show. So I know you want to talk about some more things that will be happening or some more benefits from these sessions.
Right. So our presenters will be, they've consented to give 15 scholarships to individuals, right? So excited. These scholarships include 5 money blueprint courses, 5 scholarships from one-on-one educational services, and 5 from iCreate courses. you know, yes. gosh, I mean, you probably you couldn't pay for what, you know, you couldn't pay for what they are, you're going to get on Sunday afternoon. So we want all of our young people to come out, experience another world, you know, with persons who are successful. They're young and they are successful and they're eager to help others to be successful as well. So we want to thank them wholeheartedly for putting in their time and effort into doing this young entrepreneurial session on Sunday afternoon.
And as a member of parliament, it's not easy. I know from touring the country the expectations that so the expectations what do you call it the unreasonable expectations that some of us may have of our MPs and the lack of education on the role of the member of parliament and the role of us to also hold our member of parliament accountable and have sessions with the member of parliament or turn up to wherever you are. How hard has it been? How many years are we going now?
This is my second term.
Second term.
And so, and before that, I'd started out a couple of years before I came into the politics. So it's going on eight, nine years.
What has been the hardest part of this role as member of parliament? I mean, it's really rewarding to be able to have this partnership, to put this on for your constituents who need it. But as a woman over lunch, how hard has it been to be a member of parliament in Jamaica?
It's difficult. It's time. It's time consuming. You never know. Even if somebody tells you it's time consuming, you will not know.
Unless we've walked a dangerous shoes.
Unless you walk. Yes. It's weekdays. It's nights. It's weekends. Expectations are high as to what you can deliver. The most frustrating part for me is a lot of times when I see young people and I talk to them about their future. And their inability to see it, they're only focused on the now, you know, what can you give me now? And I know that if I see you 3 months from now, you'll be in the same situation. How can I engage you in a program that will help you to transform your life and that you won't have to be sitting at that same place when I come back again?
And it's hard. And that's the focus, I think, for all of us to help young people to dream and see beyond. One more question, Minister, and then I'm going to ask Keisha to come in. Your Constituency Development Fund, there is a thought in this country that MPs have billions of dollars, billions to spend per month in their constituency. Let us enlighten for a minute.
Far from the truth. Far from the truth. We do get an allocation. It doesn't come to us personally. It's allocated to us. We can select roads that we would like to get done. The agency responsible for roads will do their assessment of the road to see if it's within the allocation we get. They will select the contractor, the work gets done, the contractor gets paid, and we are happy for the road to be done. We do get educational, an allocation for education as well.
Within that budget?
Within that budget.
Well, do you remember the figure, 20, come here, see,
50,
what's 50? It now? 50. Okay. Something like
million. But it's specific as to how much can be used for what.
Yes.
And so, for example, like education with back to school now, I've been maxing out on book vouchers that book bags and other school supplies that you literally hand out to persons who are in need, for whom a book bag costing $3,000 or $4,000 is very expensive.
It is.
Extremely expensive.
It is.
And so they're happy to be able to get that gift for their children to ease the pressure of back to school and so on. We help a lot as MPs with providing some support for funerals. Especially the funeral home expense, and you know
that's hard. Imagine,
it is. I know it is.
It's worse when you live in a place where enough people are dead from gunshot.
Yes, and we provide support to persons to offset the cost of the funeral for those persons. So yes, there is an allocation made, but it's done within a context.
You have guidelines.
Very strict guidelines. And it goes through the various agencies, and I want MPs do not get the money to spend.
So it's not in the minister's bank account. It goes through an agency, and the minister has to write to the agency to say, yes, it is approved, it can be distributed
in this way. So even for the person who comes for help with a funeral, I have to write a letter. I have to get some information from that person, the invoice from the funeral home. They have to fill out a needs assessment form. We package all of that together, send to the SDC. They're the ones who cut the check to the funeral home.
Right.
Not through the minister.
Not
to the family either. Right. So there is transparency, end-to-end transparency on that. So, yes, we do get funds allocated, but it's not into our own personal accounts at all.
At all. Just want to clarify that for those who are not sure how it worked. But I think it is about, it was like $15 million per year for constituencies, from what I remember. That's not a lot, people. It's not a lot when you have, especially when you have a large
constituency.
It's like, whoa.
It can go quickly. Yes.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much for putting on this event. I know it feels good. I can see the joy in your face. And in your voice, I can hear it, that you're able to deliver this for your constituents. And I'm asking listeners, turn up. You see, one thing, don't ever miss an opportunity. And you're not even paying for it. And I know that FHCC
right.
will be opening.
First Heritage Corporate Credit Union. Will be opening accounts there, business accounts. Mm. And that's, that's a very good thing to be doing. You have somebody there, you can ask the questions. You don't have to find your way to a bank, right there with the person to do that. Opening a bank account is difficult in Jamaica because of all the documentation you have to provide. So to get someone to help you walk through that process, there's value, a lot of value.
Doing business is hard in this country, Keisha, and I'm sure it's similar across the world. I know, because I'm an entrepreneur, and there's a lot we have to learn, taxes, marketing, like it's a whole new education.
Whole new thing.
So we're going to get all of this at Hermitage Park?
And more. It's always good to hear the information from persons who have lived it, rather than to go and, do a theoretical, let me open that book and let me try and figure it out. But to hear exactly, all right, you need to tick this specific box on the form. You can't find that in any book.
Listen, that is so true. And Minister, when you see your constituents so successful, how will it make you feel?
Oh, I mean, I'll be marketing her all over.
I know, right?
Yes.
Meet Keisha.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
It's possible.
It is possible.
This is what's possible.
It is possible.
And that's what I want to do, to get persons to think beyond where they are right now and to think that this is possible for me as well. Because if you don't have that mindset, you're just going to be right here. And I'll see you when you're 65.
Same place.
Right there. Yeah.
And we ain't trying to be there. We're trying to grow. So, Minister, I know you have a lot to do as we enter the new school year. Yeah. And you mentioned book. You bring any books? You have any great an extra book in there? Okay. Yeah. Sound like a real Jamaican.
I
can't make it two book. Of K5. What do you have, Michelle? Grade 2? You know your constituency? No, we're not. Oh, man. Minister, thanks so much. We're going to let you go because we know you have work to do. Final question for you, moving to your role as Minister of Education and Youth. It's a lot. Do you need a state minister? Do you feel? Because I realize you don't have no more state minister. Do you need a state minister? In the super ministry?
State ministers are great, obviously, because it's a large portfolio that you have. I do have youth as well.
Yes.
And I know when Minister Morgan was there, he had responsibility for youth and information. So, yes, state ministers are great.
They're great. Sound it. State ministers are great. We're going to leave it there. Thank you again, Minister, the Honorable Fayval Williams, for being here. We wish you all the best. Listeners, you know somebody from the constituency of St. Andrew Easton, call them and let them know that they need to turn up to Hermitage Park at 5 o'clock this Sunday, September 4, for a great entrepreneurship session. It will take you from one level to the next. And I remember sharing a stage with one of my greatest speakers. When I say my greatest, he's my speaker, Les Brown. And he said, your net worth is your network, or flip it, your network is your net worth. So hang out with the people who can take you to the next level.
Yep.
And I want to thank the minister again for the initiative and for all of you successful young people. And I love to say man in anything, because sometimes I say the man them now, do not look on the man them. Let's call their names. Ricardo Allen, Tyrone Wilson, and Lauren Pert, and the lone woman. Keisha Bailey. I like it. Okay. Flip it around.
Okay, so Empress, thank you so much for having me. I am going to depart and go to a press conference right now to talk about just to round out in terms of back to school to just do a summary of what to expect in the coming week.
Excellent. And I'm sure we'll cover it as well here on Nationwide 90 FM. Cliff may cover it later.
All right. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Minister.
Thank you, Keisha.
All right. And Keisha will stay with me, Minister. Thank you so much. And to your team here, thank you. It does take teamwork to make the dream work. Hermitage Massive. Yes. St. Andrew Eastern. Come out. And we say wealth. And we say entrepreneurship, as Jamaicans will say. I say entrepreneurship. What say you, Keisha?
Entrepreneurship.
Yeah. Them say N out here. And I have to say entrepreneurship.
Entrepreneur.
Yeah.
Entrepreneur.
When we come back, entrepreneurship. How to do it yourself. That's what we're going to move into with Keisha. We'll soon come.
Whatever your personal financial needs, Lasco Microfinance has a loan for you. Call or apply online today. The time by Lasco Microfinance is...
Ooh, it's 2:01 in the afternoon and it feels so good.
I'm Dennis Brooks.
I'm Alan Campbell.
I'm Floyd Green.
And I'm Garth Williams. Catch us on the Jamaican Dads Podcast right here on Nationwide 90 FM, Thursdays at 8 p.m. with a repeat on Sundays at 6 p.m.
The Jamaican Dads Podcast is all about providing men with a healthy, safe, and functional forum to tackle many of the taboo topics that concern our masculinity.
Like everyone else out there, we're dads of varying amounts of experience who come from different backgrounds and often view the world differently.
We're definitely not perfect, but we're all brethren and we're all committed to this piece of rock called Jamaica.
Too often, there are no safe spaces for men to explore the issues which are important to us.
Plus, most of the content out there about parenthood is produced by women, for women. So we think it is important that we be the change we want to see.
Follow us on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at Jamaican Dads with a Z.
And definitely join us here on Nationwide 90 FM every Thursday at 8 p.m. with a repeat on Sundays at 6 p.m. for the Jamaican Dads Podcast. It's a revolution in media.
Woman with Empress Golding.
You got me feeling wavy. This is your girl Analia, and you're listening to Every Woman with Empress Golding. Tune in Monday to Friday, 1 to 3 p.m. on Nationwide 90 FM.
Do-it-yourself. DIY recipes, hacks, and everything you can imagine, you can do it yourself. Do-it-yourself Thursday is brought to you by BH Paints. Paint it, love it with BH Paints.
We're inside the DIY for today, and many of my listeners understand on this show, Every Woman with me and Empress Golding, that I love money. And a lot of us women are afraid to talk about money. Yeah, we're afraid of that word, and I don't know what it is. But when we look at entrepreneurship, the ultimate goal is to do something that can feed your family, feed your community, feed your nation. Yeah? Economic growth. We hear it all the time. But what does it mean for us as individuals? So Keisha Bailey is with me. She will be one of the presenters at the Minister of Youth and Youth and Education, no longer information. Youth and Education, the Honorable Fayval Williams, the MP for St. Andrew Easton, will be having an event on September 4, 5 o'clock for all of the constituents to come out and learn about entrepreneurship. So she does her project today, but she's the CEO of Profit Jumpstarter. But her project today in the DIY is to help us look at ways that we can make money. Do it yourself. Right? Yeah. So Keisha, you have made, and you've made a good life for yourself coming out of Augustown.
Yeah.
Yeah. And a quick summary for those who are just turning on the radio about what Profit Jumpstarter does. And you're a Jamaican from Augustown, you're a woman. Tell me again, how did you become this entrepreneur?
So grew up in Augustown. Growing up there was hard, but I'd like to think of just my mom pushing through, because she's one of those mother, education is key. Mm-hmm. Study a book. And I love reading. I love books. So I'm a like a nerd. I love it, but it didn't always start that way. But, you know, I saw the book as the way, you know, there's a labor for learning before you grow old. So going to school now at Campion for high school, that's where I really, you know, your eye opened up to what exists past Papine. What existed, different lifestyle here. People live this place, that place, Red Hills, you know, Norbrook, Cherry Gardens. I said, what is that? Mm-hmm. So as my eyes became more open, and you know, you're going to high school, then after that, I did actuarial science at UWE because love numbers, yes. Love calculating,
you
adding
better
things.
Love numbers if you're managing so much money. Let me tell you.
So right after university, went to now start managing money professionally. Uh-huh. So I've managed money for some of the largest pension funds in Jamaica through the different roles I've had. So money growth is my thing. I know to do it well because I've done it for almost 18 years now. Mm-hmm. Still young, fresh and green, but I've always managed money and grown that money. I've won awards for the growth of the money, all kind of thing. Then went to Canada and did my MBA there in finance, graduate with honors, you know, so now international money. Yes.
I like foreign currency.
Yes.
Keep on talking.
So managing money now in Canada, I was managing over $100 billion Canadian dollars. Mm-hmm. But I didn't.
Sorry, let me just work out what that is.
100 with a B, 100 billion. Yeah, right? I had some of the largest clients there as well. Enough money. And then I just wasn't having an impact. So nice, you know, corner office, you're doing the thing, you're living the dream, but you're not really helping your people, right?
Hey, Michelle, there's something about this show. I'm working on my speech tomorrow for the Guardian Live Scholars, right? Mm-hmm. I'm the guest speaker. And I woke up every night I'm waking up early, like with these things. Yesterday, the other day, I was listening. This morning, all I kept thinking about was that word. It just kept coming at me, impact. And here you are saying, if you're not having impact, it ain't worth it. So you couldn't feel the impact?
No, because the people who I was making rich, they were already rich. So, you know, take them into multi-billion phase. But all right. So, but what about my people? I couldn't have that impact. And so I left the corporate world to start Profit Jumpstarter, where now I educate and teach persons strategies to grow their money to $1 million or more.
Right.
More. Stressing that because I'm all about abundance.
Yes.
Abundance. So I educate. Yes. People call me Keisha the teacher because that's what I do. I teach you how money work and
big
how to grow it.
You know, Keisha the teacher. Keisha the teacher. Yes.
So that's just been the journey. It's been good so far. I've worked with a lot of clients. Some of them teachers, which is why I had to be a part of this initiative, because teachers are the way forward. So I've worked with the St. Andrew High School teachers and taught them how to invest. And they are very grateful. They're going out there investing. Many of them opened them local brokerage account, international brokerage account, texting me all kind of different tickers and investment strategies. It's very good to feel that's the impact now, because these teachers can also teach the students about money. And that was my dream, to be able to know that, you know, you're paying it forward. Mm-hmm. Because the teachers who push me, so if I'm able to teach them what I know, they can help other students.
And that's a cycle. You know, you talked about impact. And this little show right here, big in my own mind, like I think I have like 5 billion listeners right now in my own mind. And it's okay to live in your world. I believe that this moment is where we will bring this impact for those listening. So, wealth creation is not something we were taught.
No.
Yeah? Especially looking at us, the African peoples of Jamaica, yeah? We are the poorest. We have the most socioeconomic challenges.
Yeah.
When I go in the juvenile centers, where I give my service, when I go in a prison with man, I be a black man, me see. Barely can you see an Indian or a white man inside prison, behind prison walls. I hate it, Keisha. And I'm saying, where do we start to educate on, you know, land, wealth, and how do we bring that in the education system? But this is education right now. Minister spoke about having these financial literacy or financial learning sessions for teachers. The teachers are complaining that the pay is too little, and we understand. But my pay is too little doing one job too.
Yes.
And so how do we now say, you're not the only one that wants to make more? How do you do what you've done for the St. Andrew teachers? How do we do this for all teachers across Jamaica, assisting the minister's vision to do it? And I'm sure some people say, well, yeah, I thought about it. None of that we want. But I think it's a great idea.
No, it's great because money is possible. Money, honestly, is easy to make. The problem is a lot of people don't know how to do it. But there are, like... That's why my course is the money blueprint, because there is a way to get money. You follow what wealthy people do and avoid what the poor people do. So if we know what the wealthy people do, which is what I teach, you're going to get money. Mm. It's a principle. It's a blueprint. If you follow it, you're going to get the money because they have, everyone else followed it and they have money.
Yeah.
So it's to learn. So when Minister said it, I said, brilliant, 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 because it is needed because the teachers will now have that passive income coming in. When you invest this money, you're not actively working for it. It's passive
working
income.
For you.
Right. So you wake up and you're checking your investment accounts. You're teaching students about that as well. It's a very powerful initiative that will leap into future generations.
Yes. And a lot of us didn't inherit that wealth and that knowledge. So time is now to learn. Let's do some DIY. We're going to go back and forth, Keisha. It's the aligners in my mouth. Keisha. You ever worn these things before? They're crazy. You had braces.
I do the retainers at night.
It's crazy. Girl, it's crazy. So I'm gonna be tongue tied, tongue twisted. Can't get my S's right, but that's okay. We go with the flow. Let's do some DIY right now. Okay, back and forth. Let's get creative. Listeners, I want you to do it too. YouTubers, write something in the chat. Let's look at all the ways we can make money, starting with the simplest thing. So I'm gonna start with this one. Walk people's dogs.
Take a talent you have that you think, you know, is my little hobby. Maybe I can braid here. You know, maybe I do makeup good for myself. I'm very good at telling people how to lose weight. I'm very good at telling people different trends and so forth. Monetize it.
How you monetize that now, Keisha? So I'm good at this. I have this talent. Yeah? How do I move for the first customer?
I've seen people just use their Instagram profile and say, here, I'm doing here this Saturday. I remember one of my friends, she does makeup. I always said, all right, we're just going to get a little room and we're going to say, people who are struggling with their makeup, you know, you don't know what to do, come and let me show you. She did that, sold out, and she's having multiple sessions now.
Love it.
You take your skill set and you say, all right, who need help? Mm-hmm. That's literally all you have to do. Mm-hmm. Go on social media. Who need help with this? Mm-hmm. You don't even have to, maybe a lot of people, you know, nervous to announce that they're doing a business.
Yeah.
So you say, who needs help with doing their makeup? Who needs help with braiding them here?
Ask a question.
People come back.
Yes. Ask a question. All right. So walk the dog, start that service, find your innate skills and talents. And listeners, write down five things that you're good at. Now we have listeners who are saying, I have no idea how to invest. I have 100,000 Jamaican. Lots of my listeners can find that right now. What am I doing with that now for flip it?
That's a question I get probably 10 times a day
in
the DMs. Keisha, what do you think? So main thing is that you need to talk to your financial advisor about what you want that money to do. So if you're saying, I want to grow the money, the financial advisor will show you all of the growth financial products. If you say, you know, I want passive income, they're going to show you the income-related financial products. And if you say, Keisha, show me a strategy, teach me a strategy, that's where I come in now to teach you how to grow it. But a couple of things. Start simple. You can do unit trust products. Very easy. Very easy. You go into the advisor. Talk to them about, tell me about the unit trust product that offer growth. Mm-hmm. They're going to list out all of them. Mm-hmm. Tell me about the unit trust products that offer income. Mm-hmm. They're going to list them out. You start putting your money. So it's not even 100,000. It's being consistent also.
Oh.
After you put in 100, can you put 1,000 more? Mm-hmm. 5,000 a month? Because that's really what pushes you now into right. that wealth.
And if you could give us one more tip. I see Shirley Lambie coming in saying, don't spend money that you don't have, says Shirley.
True.
What is the one thing that wealthy people do that poor people just haven't got it right?
They stay in their lane. Wealthy people are not swayed by the gram, right? Mm. We don't see Beyonce coming on and showing off and, you know, desperate for likes. She does do her thing. They're busy just focusing in their lane. Doing what they're doing for them, right? And they have businesses. They have businesses. So they are actively in them business. You know, they say, mind your business, drink my water, and mind my business. Yeah. That's what they're doing.
So don't be fooled by the hype. And I want to say, there are a lot of people I see, boy, them go to the car shop and take a picture in front of the car and post it, and you think that they're wealthy. They really are not. So don't watch that hype. Watch those who know. All right, Keisha, I'm sure people may want to book you. Who are you targeting as your market? And who are the people that would come to Profit Jumpstarter?
So persons who work with me, I've worked with several, probably at this point over 500 people. Mm-hmm. They are people who say, you know, Keisha, I should be further in life. You know, may I make the money, but may not have nothing for show for it. Mm-hmm. More someone to come in to teach me all the strategies to grow that money after I've made it.
Yeah.
Those are my people because they come in and I teach them the strategies to grow that money phenomenally or exponentially.
Yes. Yes.
My aim is to take people to $1 million or more because
right.
it's not hard to do. We just don't know the formula. To do it. I know me love the numbers. So
yes.
Follow the formula, you're going to get there. So
Michelle, you ready? All right, Jermaine, you ready? My listeners, are you ready? Let's give it up right now for my guest today inside the DIY, how to make your money, flip your money, Keisha Bailey, and how to just live a world where you're doing what you love and you are making impact. That's Keisha Bailey, CEO of Profit Jumpstarter. She will be at the Minister of Education and Youth's Hermitage event. It is an empowering event where you can come to learn all about entrepreneurship, knowing that's not where you're coming from, but it's where you're going. From successful young Jamaicans, right, who come from the same communities and are at the top of their game. You just need to know how to do it. So be there, 5 o'clock, September 4 at Hermitage Park. Thanks so much for being here, Keisha.
Yes, and then everyone should follow Profit Jumpstart on Instagram because I share a lot of money tips and strategies there because I'm all about helping. Mm-hmm. They can also join my newsletter, profitjumpstarter.com/newsletter. Whole heap of weekly tips. I'm all about money, and growing it. So
love
if that's
it.
What you're about, join the mailing list, follow me on Instagram.